The Goalie Mask by Mike Leonetti. It was a crisp Saturday morning in October, and Grandpa was driving me to hockey practice. It wasn't very far to the arena, but my mind was miles away. I was thinking about how much I loved playing hockey, and especially how much I loved being a goaltender. And I was thinking about my coach, Mr. Dumont. He and I didn't always agree on the best goaltending style, and I wasn't sure how to deal with that. Grandpa noticed that I was lost in thought. He turned to me and said, "Is there something bothering you, Mark?" "No, Grandpa," I replied. "I was just thinking about my team. Thanks for taking me to practice." I was trying to change the subject.
My dad used to be a goaltender, and he was really happy when I told him I wanted to become one too. One of the things I loved about it was all the special equipment, like the huge pads and the blocker and catching glove were so different from the gloves worn by other players. It was fun getting dressed before the game. I loved putting on the mask just before I went into the net. I had covered it with cool stickers with the logo of my favorite team, the Montreal Canadiens. When you're in net, you're always in the middle of the action. Everybody is watching you when you make a big save. When the game starts, a goalie has to forget about everything else and just concentrate on stopping the puck. I would do anything to stop a shot, including diving across the net. I was a pretty good goalie, and I liked the way the team counted on me. At practice, I worked on my backward skating and on my catching the puck with my glove hand.
The one part of my game that I really needed to improve was handling the puck outside the crease. All the NHL goalies could stop the puck, then pass it right away to a teammate. I tried to do that too, but I was so bad at it that Mr. Dumont had told me I had to stay in the net and not touch the puck at all. I didn't think that was fair. I knew I could be a better goalie if I just practiced more and improved my puck handling.
The next day, I asked Dad if he could play a little ball hockey with me. "Sorry, Mark, but I'm really busy," he replied. "But why don't you ask your grandpa? He used to be a goalie too, you know." Grandpa had only just moved in with us since Grandma died in September. He used to live miles away, so I had only really seen him at Christmas and didn't know him that well. I certainly didn't know that he used to be a goalie. I raced downstairs to ask him if he wanted to play. He was a bit slow on his feet, but it turned out that Grandpa had a pretty good wrist shot, and he knew a lot about being a goaltender. He showed me how to play the angles and talked to me about how important it was to bounce right back up after I made that save. That way, I'd be ready to stop the next shot. After an hour of practicing with Grandpa, I was exhausted, and my Canadian sweater was soaked in sweat, but I really felt like I was learning new skills. "Keep it up like that, Mark, and you'll be the next Jacques Plante," Grandpa joked. I had no idea who he was talking about, but I smiled anyway.
After school the next day, a couple of my friends came over to play hockey in our driveway. I put on my dad's old pads and we set up a net. Pierre and Dennis took turns firing the tennis ball at me and tried to stop every shot. Just then, my grandfather pulled up in his car. He smiled as he watched us play. "Good save, Mark," he said as I snared a shot to my catching hand. "Can I ask you a question, Grandpa?" "Sure, Mark, what is it?" "Who is Jacques Plante you mentioned the other day? Was he a famous goalie?" He smiled. "Have you boys got a few minutes?" My grandfather had a great way of telling a story, and the three of us stopped playing to give him our complete attention.
I grew up in Montreal, so the Canadiens have always been my team. They used to win the Stanley Cup every season, and they had so many great players like Maurice Rocket Richard, Henri Richard, Jean Béliveau, Doug Harvey, Bernie Geoffrion, and Dickie Moore. But my hero was Plante, because he was a goaltender just like me, my grandfather began. Pierre turned to me and said with a laugh, "Being a goaltender must run in your family." "I guess so," I replied. "Did you follow Plante's career closely, Grandpa?" "I sure did, Mark, and I'll tell you about the defining moment of his career and how it became one of the great events in hockey history." The three of us were now listening very closely, hanging on to Grandpa's every word. I remember that night like it was yesterday. I can still recall the date, November 1st, 1959. I was in New York on business and we had just closed a big deal. My boss was so happy with me, he bought us close-up seats at Madison Square Garden. He knew I was a big hockey fan, and Montreal was in town to play the New York Rangers.
The atmosphere in the Garden was amazing. There were only six teams back then, the original six: Montreal, Toronto, New York, Chicago, Detroit, and Boston. And the Canadiens were the greatest. They came to New York as champions. They had won the last four Stanley Cups in a row. The New York crowd was pumped up, hoping the Rangers could pull off a big upset. They really wanted to beat the champs from Montreal. We cheered all the Montreal stars as they came onto the ice, but the player I was most excited to see was Jacques Plante. When he skated over to the Canadiens' net, my boss turned to me and said, "There's Jake the Snake." We all laughed. "Why do they call him that?" asked Pierre. "It seems like a pretty crazy nickname." Because he was so quick and agile, he could throw out a glove or pad or just use his stick to make a save, answered Grandpa. He was always diving in all directions, twisting his body like a snake. Anything to keep that puck out of the net. He had won 4 Vezina trophies in a row. In those days, they gave the award to the goalie that allowed the fewest goals in a season.
So the game started, and it wasn't long before the Canadians faced disaster. It was still early in the first period when Andy Bathgate, the Rangers' big star, picked up a loose puck and came hurtling down the ice. His eyes narrowed and he let it go high. Hard backhand shot. The puck kept rising and Plant could not react fast enough. It hit him square in the middle of the face, and he wasn't wearing a mask. My grandfather was getting really excited, as if he were still there, doing the play-by-play of the game. No mask, I explained. How could he play without a mask? Well, believe it or not, in those days, the players didn't wear helmets and goalies didn't wear masks. Coaches thought the mask would block the goalie's view and he wouldn't see the puck. And a lot of people thought the goalie should just be tough and do whatever they could to stop a shot, even if it meant taking a puck in the face. But the puck is so hard, Dennis said. So what happened then, Grandpa? I asked. We were still standing in the driveway, but in our minds we were in Madison Square Garden in 1959.
Well, there was blood everywhere, and Plant had to leave the ice. The doctor sewed up the cut around his nose and lip with 7 stitches. His face looked pretty bad. We were standing up in the stands for about 20 minutes, wondering what would happen. The crowd was getting restless. They didn't have backup goalies on the bench in those days, so either Plant played on, or the Canadians would have to use some amateur goalie sitting in the stands. After he got stitched up, Plant told his coach he was not going back out unless he could wear a mask. Wow, I said. Did the coach let him do it? Tobe Blake was the Canadians coach and he wasn't too happy about it, but he had no choice. The coach thought the mask might affect his vision, but Plant had been using a mask in practice, so he's used to it. The coach relented and told Plant as long as he stopped the puck and the team kept winning, he could wear his mask. It wasn't a beautiful mask like the ones you see today. In fact, it was a pretty simple mask Plant had designed himself out of fiberglass. But it was light and it didn't block his vision.
Did the Canadians win the game? I asked. The New York fans gave Plant a standing ovation when he came back onto the ice with his mask and his sweater all stained with blood. He played great for the rest of the game and made 27 saves wearing the mask. The Canadians won 3-1. We left Madison Square Garden with big smiles on our faces and talk about Plant all the way back to Montreal.
After that, Plant wore the mask all the time and the Canadians went on a 19-game unbeaten streak. He even got his first shutout using the mask against the Maple Leafs a few days later, 3-0 at the Forum. That year, the Canadians won the Cup again and Plant won his 5th straight Vezina Trophy. Plant became known as the Masked Marvel because he played so well. Soon, other goalies started wearing masks too. Nobody worried about them not seeing the puck properly anymore. Every goalie wears a mask now, I said. Yes, and you can thank Jacques Plante for that, Grandpa replied. Now you boys finish playing your game.
That night, I was still thinking about the great story my grandpa told me. We turned on Hockey Night in Canada and the Canadians were playing the Maple Leafs. Mom and Dad were upstairs tucking in my sister, so I was watching the game with Grandpa. He had given me a book Plante had written about goaltending and a hockey card he had saved. I asked Grandpa if he had any stories about Plant. You know, Jacques Plant will always be remembered for using the mask, but he also had a lot of other ideas, Grandpa said about his favorite player. He changed the way goalies played the game. Plant was the first goalie to come out of his net to play the puck and the first to signal icing calls. Goalies didn't do that sort of thing. He even wore a toque for a while to stay warm in cold arenas until the coach made him take it off. It sounds like he broke all the rules, I said. No, Mark, my dad said, walking into the room. He really didn't break any of the rules. He just believed in what he was doing, and he knew his own abilities. And look how he made the game safer for everyone. Sometimes you don't follow the trends, you set them yourself. That's what Plant did. He knew that wearing a mask would make him a better goalie, and that would help the team win more games.
I thought about what my dad had said and knew that he was right. Jacques Plant had the courage to stand up for his beliefs. The next day I told my dad, Dad, I have to do what Plant did and talk to my coach. If I practice a lot, I can become a much better goalie. But he has to let me come out of the crease and get to those loose pucks. Otherwise, I will never get better. That's a good idea, Mark, said Dad. Why don't you ask Grandpa to help you out with your puck handling skills? You can learn a lot from experienced people like Mr. Dumont and your Grandpa. We support you, Mark, but you have to listen to what your coach has to say. I can talk to Mr. Dumont if you want me to. No, Dad, I'll handle it on my own. Just like Jacques Plante did with his coach. I spent the next week doing drills with Grandpa in the driveway. I worked on using my goal stick, trying to place the puck in just the right spots for my defenseman. My next game was on Sunday morning, and I really wanted to show the coach that I could come out of the crease like a real NHL goalie and pass the puck out of danger if I had to.
At practice on Thursday, I told Mr. Dumont about all the drills I've been doing and showing him how much better I was at handling the puck. He looked impressed and told me I could leave the net if I felt sure of myself. For once, I was really feeling confident.
On Sunday, the whole family came to watch the game. My team won 3-0. I was up and down all game and I was quick to sprawl to make a stop. But I was fast enough to recover and set myself up for another save. I was twisting myself in every way and made some great saves by kicking out my pads. I love to hear the whoop the puck made when it hit my pads or ended up in my catching glove. A couple of times the puck came skipping down towards me and I shot out the crease and flicked it away to a defender. The whole time I was thinking, I am Jake the Snake, the masked marvel. My teammates mobbed me after the game and the coach was waiting for me at the dressing room door. He gave me a pat on the back and said, "That was a well-earned shutout, Mark. You played like an all-star out there." "Thanks, coach. Does that mean I can play my game without you getting upset with me like before?" The coach smiled at me. "Well, Mark, you keep stopping the puck and everything will be fine, but don't forget that you still got a lot to learn." My grandpa could see me talking to the coach and gave me a thumbs up. "Okay, coach, I'm willing to learn," I answered. I was feeling like Jean-Claude talking to Toe Blake. Maybe one day I'll be able to play for the Montreal Canadiens too.